My dear children, now let's complete all the exercise which is given in our workbook, okay? Now everyone open your workbook, page number 3. First lesson, that is Oliver finds a hoe. Now look at the first Roman letter, that is check the correct meanings of these words. You can see 5 questions there. Look at the first one. The word which is given there is doctor, and 3 options are given there. They are respectively option A, nurse, option B, chemist, option C, physician. And now you have to find which is the correct meaning of the word doctor. And the answer is option C, physician. Okay? Physician means doctor. So the answer is physician. Then look at the second question now, prison. And the options given below are option A, police, option B, jail, option C, punishment. And the right answer is option B, jail. So prison means jail. Look at the third question now, dialogue. And the 3 options are respectively option A, enjoyment, option B, disagreement, and option C, conversation. And the right answer is option C, conversation. Okay, dialogue means conversation. And now let's go on to the fourth question. The question is chaos. Okay, option A, confusion, option B, choir, option C, gossip. And the right answer is option A, confusion. Okay, chaos means confusion. Then now look at the fifth question, character. The given options are option A, cartoon, option B, personality, option C, disaster. And the right answer is character means personality, option B. Okay. Dear children, now look at the second Roman letter. That is fill in the blanks with the synonyms of the words given within the brackets. Choose from the box. Okay. Look at the first question now. Mrs. Marley and Rose were nervously waiting for the doctor. And here, first of all, we have to find the word which is given within the brackets. Okay. Here, the word nervously is given within the brackets in the question. So, we have to find the meaning of the word nervously from the words given above. Okay. The word anxiously, which is present in the bots, means nervously. Okay, dears? So, the answer is anxiously. Anxiously means nervously. Okay? Now, look at the second question. Oliver said that the thieves wanted him to loot the house. Here, the word which is given within the brackets is loot. Right? So, we have to find the meaning of the word loot. Loot means rob. Okay, so the answer is rob. Then third question, the police came to question about the robbery. Here the word which is given within the brackets is question. And from that box we have to find the word which has the similar meaning of this question. So the answer is inquire. Okay, inquire means question. Then fourth question, Oliver lived blissfully with Mrs. Marley and Rose. Here the word within the bracket is blissfully. And the meaning of this word blissfully is happily. Then fifth question, it is bad manners to stare at people. In this question, we can see the word stare within the brackets, right? So the synonym of the word stare is gaze. G-A-Z-E. Gaze means stare. Okay. Sixth question. We have never heard Suman speak to anybody impolitely. Here the word impolitely is given within the brackets. The meaning of the word impolitely is rudely. Okay. So the answer is rudely. Seventh question. If we destroy the forest, not a single animal will live. The word within the bracket is live. And live means survive. Okay. So the answer is survive. And eighth question. The alarm was so loud that it shocked me. The word within the bracket is shock, and the synonym of shock is startled. Okay, hope it's clear to you. Yes, now shall we move on to the next Roman letter? Yeah, children, the next one, you have to make contractions of the word pairs given in the box and then fill in the blanks with the contractions. Okay, so first what you have to make, you have to make contractions of the word pairs that is given in the box. Yes, now you can see nearly seven word pairs which is given in the box, right? Yeah, first of all you have to find each pair's contraction. Okay, now first let us recall what is a contraction. Hope you have already learnt about it, right, Ma? Yeah. First, I will tell you what is a contraction. Okay. A contraction is a shortened form of a word or a group of words. This contraction, it omits the certain letters or sounds. And in most of the contractions, an apostrophe represents the missing letters. Okay. Now, I will give you one or two examples of contraction. For example, can not, can plus not. The contraction of this word can not is can't. Okay, C-A-N apostrophe T. Then do not, that is do not. Do plus not. The contraction of the word do not is don't. D-O-N apostrophe T. Yes. Now, my dear children, you looked out the words, the word pairs which is given in that box. Okay, first one, you look there. First one, they would. First, you have to find the contraction of this word, they would. That is, they apostrophe D. Right? Yeah. Then second one, you look at that word. Which word is it? Did not. Right? Did not. The contraction of the word did not is didn't. The next one, will not. Will not. The contraction of this word will not is won't. Next one, cannot. That is can't. The next one, could not. That is couldn't. Next one, have not. That is haven't. Next one is it is. The contraction of this pair is it's. Okay, now my dear children, you look out the sentence one by one. There are seven sentences given below, right? Yeah, we have to read these seven sentences, and one among the seven word pairs which is given above, we have to take one among this and fill it in each blank. Okay, one word pair, you can use it in one sentence. In the same way, look at the first one now. The doctor spoke in whispers so that Oliver dash wake up. So here the right word pair is did not. And we have to write the contraction of that word. So we have to write it as didn't. Okay. Look at the second sentence. Mrs. Marley and Rose decided that dash help Oliver. They would help Oliver. And you have to write the contraction. So you can write it as they apostrophe D. Then third one, Jimmy tried hard but he turned the door handle. Here the correct answer is could not. And here you have to write the contraction. So you can write it as couldn't. Then fourth one, Rena dash be coming for the match. The right answer is will not. The right answer is will not. And you have to write the contraction. So you can write it as want. Okay. Then fifth one, I'm hungry as I dash eaten breakfast today. The right answer is have not. But you have to write the contraction. So you can write it as haven't. Sixth one, bring me the book dash the one with the blue cover. Answer is it is. You have to write the contraction, so the answer is it's. Okay. Seventh one, Vicky is very worried because he dash find his cat. Here the right one is cannot, and you have to write the contraction, so you can write it as can't. Okay, my dear children, now look at the next one. Complete these sentences in your own words then circle the correct sentence type and remember to punctuate the sentences. Okay, so you can see some of the incomplete sentence given below. From you have to complete these sentences, you have to make it a complete sentence by adding some words, and then you have to find in which sentence type that particular sentence belongs to, and then according to the type of sentence you have to punctuate each sentences. Okay, now let us make the first one a complete sentence. Look at the question now. Oliver Twist was written dash. We have to make it a complete sentence, so we can add a group of words to make it a complete sentence. For example, you can write it as Oliver Twist was written by Charles Dickens. Okay, and then you have to find the type of sentence. To which sentence type do this sentence belongs to? It is a statement, right? So you have to circle option A, statement. Then you have to punctuate it. At last you have to put a full stop. Okay, second question. First we have to complete that sentence, so we can write it, what did Dr. Losbernay say about Oliver? Okay, and this is a question, so to which type of sentence do this belong to? It belongs to question, option B, question. And since it is a question, we have to use the punctuation mark, question mark. Okay, yeah. Now look at the third question. Yes, take the dash, we have to complete this sentence. We can write take the dog out into the garden. Okay, take the dog out into the garden. And to what type of sentence do this sentence belong to? It is an imperative sentence. Okay, it is an imperative sentence, and so we have to use the punctuation mark, full stop. Yes, it seems to be like a command or order, so it belongs to imperative sentence. Fourth one, we have to complete the sentence first, so we can write it, the children have planned a surprise party for their teacher. The children have planned a surprise party for their teacher. What type of sentence is this? It is a statement, so we can use the punctuation mark, full stop. Next one, oh no, I forgot to turn off the lights and fan at home. So we have completed the sentence, and here then we have to find to what type do this sentence belong to. It comes under exclamatory sentence. Okay, that is option D, exclamatory. Next one, you must remember to dash. We have to complete the sentence first. So you must remember to wake me up early morning at tomorrow. Okay, you must remember to wake me up early tomorrow. That's enough. Okay, you can write it as, you must remember to wake me up early tomorrow. To what type of sentence do this belong to? It is an imperative sentence because it is a order. Okay, and you have to use the punctuation mark, full stop. And for fifth question, that is exclamatory sentence, at last you have to use the exclamation mark. Okay ma? Yeah. The next, seventh question, how was the dash? First let us complete this sentence, how was the play? Okay, it is a question, so option B, question. And then you have to end the sentence with a question mark. Okay dears, I think you have understood this, and not only this sentence, you can complete this sentence with any words of your own. Okay, this is just an example. If you write this also, it is not a matter, and if you frame your own sentence also, it doesn't matter. My dear children, now look at the next exercise. That is, you have to look at the picture and write four different types of sentences about it. Okay, and finally you have to remember to punctuate the sentences correctly. Now let's recall, what is a sentence? A sentence is a group of words that gives a complete meaning, right? Yeah. What are the four kinds of sentence? That is statement. Statement is otherwise called as declarative sentence. Then next one is interrogative sentence. Interrogative sentence is otherwise called as question. Then imperative sentence and then exclamatory sentence. So what are the four types of sentence? Recall it once again. Statement, question, imperative and exclamatory. Okay, now we have to see this, look at this picture, and then from this picture we have to frame four sentences, each sentences for this, each of this different types of sentence. Okay, so statement, first let us frame a statement. I will tell you a sentence and you can also write any other sentence if you wish. Just try it, if not, write the sentence. Okay, dears? Yeah. For statement, the girl likes working in the garden with the elderly gentleman. Okay, the next one is question. Is the elderly gentleman the gardener or the girl's grandfather? So for question, you have to end with question mark. Then third one, imperative. Be careful of the thorns. Okay, for this you have to use the punctuation mark, full stop. Then exclamatory sentence. Example, I will tell you how healthy the dahlia plant looks. And finally, you have to end it with a exclamatory mark. Okay. Now, look at the next exercise. Fill in the blanks with interjections from the boards. Remember to add exclamation marks. Okay. Whenever we write interjections, we have to write with exclamatory mark. Okay, dears. Now, look at the words in the boards. That is, shh, hey, wow, oh, hooray. And these are the words given in the boards. We have to use these interjections and fill in the blanks which are given below. Okay. Look at the first question now. He is a merry child. Which interjection can come before this sentence? We can use the interjection oh. Okay. Oh, he is a merry child. And second one, we have to use the interjection before the word that, sorry, before the sentence, that's my bag, not yours. Hey, that's my bag, not yours. Third one, shh, grandpa is sleeping. Fourth one, the food is delicious, mom. Fifth one, wow, your computer is super fast. Sixth one, hooray, the holidays have begun.